I think everybody sitting at home wants the answer to the same question. Did you murder your wife?
I'm aware that suspicion has turned to me. And it's turned to me, one, because I am her husband. And that's natural thing. And I've heard all the statistics on all the news programs about how someone, husband, ex-husband, boyfriend, is someone who statistically would be one who would be responsible for her disappearance. And I'm sorry, I forgot your question.
Yeah, one with you, 20.
River Road heading south, we'll have a park.
Roger that.
About 9:30 this morning. Martha Stewart had just come on, I think. I went fishing on the bay, got to the marina maybe 11 or so. I launched my boat. She was going to walk Mackenzie, our dog, and go shopping. We had dinner plans tonight with her folks, Christmas Eve dinner. I got back about 4:30, and the dog was already in the backyard. His leash was on still, and it was all muddy. And it doesn't make sense. She wouldn't just leave. She would never just leave. And then I called all our friends. And then I called mom, Sharon, Lacey's mom. I called her.
Her cell phone's here. Her keys and her purse are here.
Her car is in the driveway. I mean, obviously something has happened. Why are we just standing around here?
We need to work out a timeline.
Look, I told you. I told you what we know already. Scott called and said Lacey's missing. Ron called you and we came. We came and we should be in the park looking.
Mrs. Roach,
I mean, she
ma'am.
Could have fallen and hit her head. She could be unconscious. My God, she could be in labor. Please, we have got to get there. Please.
Sure. You're her father?
Stepfather.
Brother and sister?
Yeah, I'm Brent. This is Amy.
Okay, look, I know this is hard on all of you, but we have officers in the park. We are not losing time. I promise.
Just finish, please. Just finish asking your questions.
Have you fought recently? Did you argue?
No. No. No.
No. Has she ever left before?
Never.
I'm sorry, Mr. Peterson. I have to ask these questions. Mr. Peterson?
Ask me. Ask anything.
The two of you had no problems then. Your marriage is secure.
Our marriage is perfect. We're having a baby.
So there's no reason to think that Mrs. Peterson has left you?
No.
No reason to think that Scott would give her cause to go?
No. No. Scott and Lacey are perfect. They're the couple everybody wants to be.
Let them ask their question, Sean.
Come on, Dad. They're beautiful together.
Are we done?
I'm just trying to help.
Wow. Come on. You're crashed, okay?
Watch out!
You drank too much.
No, I'm not drunk enough. That's the problem.
Oh. You're just a cheap date, Tommy.
No, I'm a drunk date. Ugh.
Would you get up off the lawn?
Oh, please, don't take advantage.
Come on. Come on.
Actually, scratch that. No, please, do take advantage. I love nothing more than what a pregnant woman take advantage of me.
Hi.
Hey, what are you doing up, buddy? Come on.
He woke up, said he had a dream.
Oh, no. Leave it, Linda. Leave it.
I've been talking to you guys to be home soon, but you just wouldn't go back to sleep. Come on, cowboy. Let's go.
Here we go.
Hop on.
Here we go.
Got it?
I'll be right in.
Hold on tight. All right, here we go.
Hey, give a little extra, will you? We were later than we said.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You have 5 new messages. No saved messages.
Hey, guys. It's me, Scott. I just want to double check that we're on for New Year's. Call me up. Bye-bye. It's me again. You guys seen Lacey? She's not here and she didn't leave a note. Let me know.
Hello? What? Whoa, slow down. Donna. What?
Interrupted. Scott Peterson, a Modesto resident, told police that he left his pregnant wife
Donna
Lacey
says something's happened. Something's happened to Lacey.
Go fishing at the Berkeley Marina. His wife had said she was going to take the family dog Mackenzie for a walk in East La Loma Park.
No, we see. We see. She's on the news right now.
She's tall with dark hair. She is 8 months pregnant and was last seen wearing black slacks and a white top. If anyone
where are you
has
right
any
now?
Information regarding her whereabouts,
we gotta get over there right now. God, look how many people are here.
Oh man, I can't believe this.
There's Donna and Angela. What are the police saying?
I don't know. They talked to the Roaches, but we don't know what happened yet.
I don't understand. No one's seen her all day?
No, Amy saw them both last night at the salon.
I called this morning, but I got the machine. Are you sure you're up for this?
Is Lacey in the park? Well, they think so, but I'm up for it.
Detective Ross is handing you a recent photo of Mrs. Peterson. Now, she was last seen wearing black pants and a white pullover. Also, Mrs. Peterson is 8 months pregnant. Now, the park runs about 5 miles east to west, a mile north to south. I want the A-team to take the west side, B the east. We got to cover every square inch of this place. All right, let's move out.
Team up, guys.
I smelled bleach when I was back at the house.
Could have been coming off the pool.
Yeah. Yeah, it could have been.
Go. What is
Merry Christmas,
you?
Baby.
But for this Modesto family, the holidays are now filled with fear. Lacey Peterson is 5'1", about 140 pounds. She has brown hair and brown eyes. She is 8 months pregnant.
I'm going to head back over, okay?
She could have hit her head. She could be hurt in the hospital somewhere. You know, somebody could have...
Don't think the worst. Don't do that to yourself.
Somebody could have taken her. We don't know. We don't know what happened, but...
What?
I don't think she's in the park.
Officer, it's okay. No. He's with us.
What can I do?
Hey, how's Kate? She doing okay?
Yeah, she's gonna leave Sammy with my folks. Come back later.
She needs to rest.
Yes, try stopping her. Nobody's getting any sleep till we find Lacey.
Doc. Hey. How you holding up? Kinda numb.
Are your folks coming up from San Diego?
Yeah, I talked to them, so...
What the?
Sorry.
It's okay. Okay.
I saw her.
You saw her? Where'd you see her, man?
I saw her walking her dog right on this street.
When did you see her?
Yesterday, Christmas Eve, a pretty pregnant woman, very pregnant.
You need to tell the police, ma'am.
Could you have them call me?
All right.
If somebody hurts her, I swear to God, if somebody hurts her...
She's gonna be fine, Brent. We just have to...
She should have been there to protect her. Damn, I should have been there.
Yeah, me too, Brent. What the hell?
Got a warrant to search your home, Mr. Peterson, and your vehicles.
But why?
Just routine. We're looking for any indication of where she might have gone.
Well, she didn't go anywhere. You know, she didn't just run off somewhere.
Peterson, I understand.
No, I mean, she's not here at the house either, okay? She's taken, or she's hurt somewhere out there,
stop.
Not
Make
here.
Make it easy, all right? Listen to me. We're not going to stop looking. All right, this is just procedure. What we're doing, we're here to find Lacey. We're here to help you.
I'm sorry. Okay, yeah, I just,
Why don't you come down to the station with us? We'll run over a few questions.
Don't you guys want me to stay here and help you find whatever it is you're looking for?
Mr. Peterson, get in the car, please.
Yeah, why don't you take Mackenzie inside?
Yeah, sure. I'll be right back.
The Sun Carrington Foundation was established in 1999 after Julie and Carol Sun were abducted in Yosemite. We worked with the Levies last year when Chandra went missing. We have strong ties to the community. We are an advocate for families of the missing. My job is to help you through this. The Foundation's job is to get Lacey back safely. The first thing we need to do is set up a search center. We use this room for the Sun volunteers.
Oh. We're the Petersons. We're Scott's parents.
Jackie. Lee.
Oh, Sharon. I'm so sorry. So sorry. How could this happen? How could this happen?
Has anyone called? It isn't a kidnapping.
No. No calls, no notes, nothing.
No, she's just gone. Scott said goodbye yesterday morning. She was gone when he got back.
We'll find her, Ron. Find her and bring her home.
Sharon, where's Scott?
Did you speak to anyone, Scott, at the marina?
I didn't have conversations with anyone.
Did you see anybody?
I might have nodded to a few people before I launched. I don't know.
See, we need to confirm your whereabouts. The marina receipt you gave us doesn't have a timestamp.
Guys, we've already been through this. I towed the boat to the marina. I got to the bay around 11. I motored out to Brooks Island.
You can't just take your word for it.
Nothing was biting. It was getting choppy. I headed back in.
But what time was that?
I already told you what time that was. Stop asking me the same questions over and over and over again.
You use bleach on your floors?
We have someone who cleans for us.
A cleaning woman. She doesn't use straight bleach. We asked.
Did you mop up when you got home last night?
Yeah, it was dirty.
Cleaning woman said she just washed them.
We have a dog. They get muddy.
What were you fishing for?
Sturgeon.
Yeah? Big fish. What'd you use for bait?
I don't know.
Your neighbor across the street told us that Lacey would open the blinds every morning.
No.
Likes to let the sun in.
She didn't open yesterday, though.
Yeah. Yesterday they were down. It was cold outside. It was like 40 degrees.
40 degrees? Man, it must have been freezing out there on the bay.
Can't remember what bait he used. I remember the bait I used when I was 5 years old. First time my dad took me fishing.
Frank! Hey, Detective Ross!
Hey, Tommy. Now's really not a good time.
This woman, she saw Lacey walking her dog yesterday. Yesterday, she saw her in the morning.
We'll check it out.
Okay.
Say hi to Kate.
Scott!
Yeah,
Scott!
Excuse me. Can I talk to you for a second?
Scott! Hey!
I don't think they believe me.
You think who doesn't believe what?
They should be out there looking for her, not asking me about bait and bullshit.
Well, they are looking. Hey, Scott, they got a whole army out.
No, they're questioning me like I'm a suspect.
But that's what they do. You say you went fishing, they confirm it. Lacey could have left something in the house.
They think I did something.
Well, hey, no. Scott, come on. No way. Look, come to the restaurant, all right? Calm down. Just calm down.
No, I can't stay in one place. I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't.
Yes.
Mr. Peterson claimed he went fishing on Christmas Eve.
Yes. He produced a boat launch receipt from the Berkeley Marina dated December 24th.
Yes. Mr. Peterson paid the fee to launch his boat, but has anyone reported seeing him on the water?
No, at this point, no. Yes, ma'am.
There's no proof he actually went fishing, then?
We're asking for the public's help in confirming Mr. Peterson's alibi.
Is Scott Peterson a suspect in his wife's disappearance?
No.
Has he been cleared?
No, ma'am. No, he has not been cleared. Yes.
What was she wearing the last time she was seen?
Black pants with a white pullover.
Do you have any suspects?
Listen to the questions they're asking, Tommy. I mean, they're saying that he did it.
No.
They're starting down that road. They're implying, insinuating.
Didn't do anything.
Oh, but it would make such a great story, wouldn't it? You know what they're going to do? They're going to take a perfect couple, and they're going to turn them into a horror show. Watch them.
Scott doesn't have any skeletons.
Watch them, Tommy. These people come to town expecting the worst.
Scott, is there anything else you can think of? Anything that can help us?
If there was anything else to say, he would have said it.
There are things husbands and wives keep between them. We can't afford secrets.
No. There's nothing. I told everything. I can't think of what else to say. I don't think it's not going to help me talking to the press.
Scott, they can only learn about Lacey through us.
I won't make it. I'll fall apart.
Then let them see that. Let him see how much you love her.
They don't want to see that. You heard him today. They don't care. The press has a victim. They want a villain now.
Hello?
Hey, it's me.
I miss you. Are you back?
No, I'm still out of town, sweetie. Sorry we couldn't spend Christmas together.
Me too.
You know what? I'll be home soon. And after January 26th, I'm like all yours, sweetie.
Good. I can't wait.
I'll talk to you later.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Dixie, find her. Find her.
Something wrong with the hound?
No, dog's fit. This woman didn't leave on foot.
Husband has her walking through the park sometime after 9:30 morning of the 24th.
If she went anywhere, she went in a car. Her scent stops here.
The first time I heard about Scott, Lacey called me from college. And she said she'd met the man she was going to marry. I drove down to San Luis Obispo to meet him. We had dinner plans with Scott, and he met us at the restaurant door. And he says, "It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Rocha." And he escorts us in, and there are two beautiful rose bouquets on the table, white for me and red for Lacey. They're a fairy tale couple, and he's the prince. I love Scott for how he's taken care of Lacey. The person I know would not hurt my daughter.
Did he hear? The reward fund went up to $500,000. I logged 100 new volunteers since 9 this morning. We've got folks coming in from all over the place. Dozens more searching up and down the Tuolumne and Merced, San Joaquin. People just, they just need to help her. Have a seat.
Scott here?
I don't know. He was. But, he comes in the mornings before work. Checks the website, talks to the volunteers.
Before work? He's working?
He's not going on the road, I don't think. But, you know, just working on the phones.
How can he keep working?
Because he knows Lacey's coming home.
Mr. Vignati.
Yes, sir.
Todd Dewey, KNBS, out of Oakland. Wonder if we might do an interview with you.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Kay.
Hey. Coming or going?
Sorry, going. I gotta show a house.
I was just telling Donna, Lacey wouldn't believe it. All this for her.
No, she'd never believe it.
We should have never moved here.
Lacey wanted to raise Connor here with her family.
But if we hadn't, maybe she'd still be here.
The town didn't take Lacey, Scott. You know, everybody's desperate to find her. It's not that. It's... I don't want to think about what it is.
Well, I can't think about anything else. I can't sleep from thinking about it so much. Every time I go home, I walk in that house.
You know what? Me and Tommy come over and we'll make you a meal, okay? You don't have to be alone, Scott.
Yeah, you don't. I appreciate it, but you don't have to do that.
You and Lacey do less for us?
There are reporters, Kate. They're camped out on my street. You have to go past them
There's
to get inside.
There's cameras everywhere. You know, the whole town's under a microscope.
Reporters are going to call you. They could bother Sammy.
Let them call me. I'll answer whatever they ask. I'll tell them anyone who knows Scott Peterson believes in him.
Thank you.
Come on, have a seat right here, Mr. Vignati. How long have you known Lacey and Scott?
My wife and I have known Lacey since we were kids. We used to play together on our dad's farm. Scott, we met when I started dating.
Friendly with Scott?
Yeah, he's one of my best friends.
So you don't buy into the speculation?
If you knew him like I did, you wouldn't even ask. Scott loves Lacey. I've seen how they are with each other. I've seen how he is with my son. He's going to be a wonderful father.
You don't want to say anything about Lacey? The town's really rallying around her.
Well, she, to know Lacey is to love her. And everyone in Modesto knows her.
So you're shocked at all this media attention?
No.
No? Why not?
She's pregnant. She's gone missing on Christmas Eve. It's a nightmare.
You good? Okay. Okay, it's going to be just like that. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. In.
Can I talk to you, Scott?
Yeah, sure, Dennis. Let me just get rid of this guy. Why don't you wait inside? I'll be right in. That's all we know right now.
Oh, but please.
You know, there's something I gotta take care of right now. Excuse me.
Scott, anything please?
I don't know.
Wait.
Hey, Scott. He just drove off. Said, wait in the house, and drove off. She's my daughter. You think he just forgot I was inside?
How many things does Scott have on his mind?
How many things do I have? How many do you have? I got a friend, tells me he's seen Scott out on the golf course. Saw him on the back nine, playing. He's playing golf?
Dad.
I mean, how does he afford a private country club anyway?
His parents have money.
Scott's too proud to take handouts. Wasn't that the line? Scott's working three jobs to pay his way through college.
I trust him.
Hello.
You'd feel better if you confess. Go to the police station and get this off your chest.
Go to hell.
Take them to Lacey. Show them where she is. Spare her family.
I am her family. She's my wife. Why don't you spare me? You hear me? Hello? Hey, it's me.
Hi. What's wrong? You sound funny.
I have to tell you something. I have to confess something. I lied. When I told you I'd never been married, I lied. I was married. Once. But my wife went missing. A year ago. And I lost her.
I don't understand. What do you mean?
She's gone. She's gone.
Why would you not tell me this?
I don't like to talk about her. It hurts too much to talk about her.
I want you to be able to tell me everything.
I want to, Amber. I will. I will, I'll tell you. Just not tonight, okay?
I love you.
I promise, Amber, I'll never lie to you again. I love you too.
Good night.
Good night.
Come here, babe. Let's get you ready for bed.
Come on, let's go.
And Peterson families have come together tonight with their extended family. Thousands have come here on New Year's Eve to pray for the safe return of Lacey Peterson. This local story is now rapidly grabbing the attention of California and the nation as a whole. Volunteers have arrived from across the region, donations from across the country. The reward fund has ballooned to $500,000. We can all see our own daughter, our own sister, in the face of Lacey Peterson. That she is pregnant and missing since Christmas Eve makes this tragedy all that harder to bear. Her husband, Scott Peterson, has been consistently media shy. So far, police refuse to call Peterson a suspect.
Listen to this one. We have prayers for Lacey in our hearts. We know she will be found alive and well. Goldsboro, North Carolina.
Bridgewater, Massachusetts, my heart goes out to you. Whenever I see Lacey's face on the TV, I can't help but think my own daughter. My thoughts and prayers are with you.
Come on, guys. You're shooting before it gets cold.
These people signing on the website, they're from everywhere.
Kate, seriously, come on. You haven't eaten since this morning.
I'm fine, Mom. Don't worry. I went to the doctor yesterday.
And?
The baby is fine. The baby's just fine. I don't have to see her again till next month.
Lacey's shower was supposed to be Saturday.
We'll just have to do our showers together when she gets back. Donna, what was that?
He asked how much his house was worth, okay?
Who?
Scott. He asked how much he could get for his house.
It doesn't mean anything.
Doesn't it? Why would he ask me that, huh? Why?
What did he say exactly?
Oh, he said he doesn't want Lacey coming home to all this. All what? What sense does that make? What else is Lacey going to come home to?
A new house. A new town. I don't know. Christ, Donna, think about it. What if she was taken out of the front yard? You'd want to come home to that? You'd want to relive that every time you went outside for the newspaper? Think about it.
I have. Don't you think I've gone over every possible scenario?
Maybe Scott is just protecting her.
Maybe he knows she's not coming home.
We're sorry we have to do this. We have to confirm your story.
You think she's dead? You think that Scott... do you think that he...
We haven't cleared him yet.
Yes, we think he killed her.
I had no idea. I didn't know that he was married.
We believe you, Amber.
Could you tell them that? Could you tell that to her family? Tell them that I didn't know?
Yes, of course. Of course, I promise. You did the right thing. You called us.
I want to help them. Just tell me how. I'll do anything.
Amber, how long did you know him?
We met a couple of months ago, November. A friend introduced us at a party.
So it wasn't serious?
I thought it was. I thought that he might be the one. I should have suspected something. I should have known.
You're a victim in this. He lied to you.
He was out of town all the time. He'd traveling. He'd be in Europe sometimes, in Mexico. But it was like he would lose track today of where he said he was the day before.
Is this your daughter?
Yeah, she really loves Scott.
Amber, you say you'll do whatever you can to help us.
So, Amber, Scott's still calling you?
Amy?
Hey, Kate. I just needed to catch my breath.
We're gonna find her. You just have to keep telling yourself.
I know, and I do. It's just, I have this picture of her in my head. You know, they went to the salon the night before.
I know.
I cut Scott's hair, but I couldn't stop looking at Lacey and her belly and thinking, I get to be there when Connor is born. I get to hold my nephew in the hospital. And I keep seeing her there, smiling, like she can't turn it off. She was happy and safe. She was safe.
We heard from a Fresno woman.
She claimed she was romantically involved with Scott.
No.
We asked him about that.
He said no.
She passed the polygraph.
She produced these.
sick.
Now we know why he didn't want to be on TV.
Not one guy back in 87. Fish picked away at him so bad there wasn't anything left of him. Cops couldn't ID him. He donated him to science. They cut it, T.R.
Something wrong, Skip?
I'm getting a picture here. Who's that? Is that a body?
Could you let us by? Excuse me. Please.
Why are you standing behind them?
You comment.
Hey, Mr. Peterson, can you find
him? Hi, got dinner.
It's your club. At one of the month. Came today. I was going to open it, but I figured I'd wait till she got back. Hello?
Mr. Peterson, can I ask you for an interview?
What?
An interview.
Hey, no. I said I'm not giving any more interviews, okay?
Can you comment on the sonar image being consistent
what?
With that of a body?
Consistent with what?
Body.
Authorities now say that sonar pinpointed something in the waters off the Berkeley Marina, but have refused to speculate as to what it was. A retrieval attempt will be made within 24 hours. Lacey Peterson.
They're not saying it's a body.
Pregnant when her husband reported her
missing. I don't know if it's a body.
In recent days, the investigation has focused its attention on the waters where Scott Peterson was known to be fishing on Christmas Eve.
It's consistent. That's all they said. His shape is consistent with the body.
Lacey Peterson has been missing since Christmas Eve. She was last seen.
I kept asking myself why that word. Why on earth would he use that word? Why would he say missing? Why wouldn't he say, Mom, Lacey's not home. I can't find her. He said missing, like he'd thought it through.
It's not her, Scott. Yeah, you gotta know that.
I know. I'm gonna go down to LA, San Diego too, set up more searches.
Good. Why so far south?
Lacey's not in the bay, Tommy. She could be anywhere by now. Think of my. Stay down there a couple of days and get away from the press.
And stay away from the press pretty good as is.
Hey, a grieving mother is much better than a grieving husband, Tommy.
Shit, Scott. Talk like that, you sound like people say you are.
Well, how do people say I am?
It's just how you come across, not talking to the media.
How do I come across?
Cold.
If I do an interview, it's all about me, trying to figure me out.
So what?
The media gets its ratings by making me guilty. They'll twist what I say and how I say it.
The public will see, Scott. Let's see what we see.
I can't cry on cue, Tommy.
We got nothing to say.
Hey, Tommy,
come on, Tommy, drop it. Just one comment, please.
feel trapped. Gonna run? Hope so. He runs. He's guilty.
Well, we nail him, the press leaves town.
They love this. Pretty white girl with good teeth. Pregnant, Christmas Eve. Perfect. You're going down, Scotty.
We don't know how long we expect to wait, but once they have a visual, the news should come quickly. Of course, if this does turn out to be a body, it may be hours before we receive confirmation. Okay, now wait a minute. What we're hearing is that they have not found a body. No body. No, they have not found a body, but it's a ship's anchor that they've found.
I'm going to ask you one time, Scott. Did you cheat on Lacey?
No. Why would I?
Amber Fry.
I loved Lacey Brent.
You loved her?
I love her. But I was unfaithful. I had an affair. I told her about it.
You should have told us. Why didn't you? Why didn't you tell us?
How's that look? How does it look now if I admit to having an affair?
It looks worse, Scott. It looks worse if you lie. I would like to confirm that on January 16th, Scott Peterson did admit to me that he was having an affair with a Fresno woman. I confronted him with this allegation after viewing pictures of him with this woman.
I met Scott Peterson on November 20th. I was introduced to him. I was told he was unmarried. Scott told me that he was not married. We did have a romantic relationship.
I would like Scott to know that I trusted him and stood by him in the initial phases of my sister's disappearance.
When I discovered that he was involved in the Lacey Peterson disappearance case, I immediately contacted the Modesto Police Department.
Lacey, the last month has been the most disturbing and emotional time of my life. As your older brother, I only wish that I had the opportunity to be there to defend you from the person that decided to take you away from me. Wherever you may be, I hope you know how much I love you and how important you are to me. My search for you will never end.
I'm very sorry for Lacey's family and the pain that this has caused them. And I pray for her safe return as well.
Since Scott is no longer communicating with anyone in Lacey's family, I am no longer supporting him. Scott has not been forthcoming with information regarding my sister's disappearance. I'm only left to question what else he may be hiding from me.
Hello.
Hi. I've been trying to call you. I left messages.
I called you back, Scott. Your voicemail was full.
Yeah, the press keeps calling. I can't delete the messages fast enough.
I had to take my phone off the hook on account of the reporters.
I'm sorry, Amber. I'm sorry you're going through this.
I told the truth and I had to tell the truth.
That's good. It's good. I don't blame you, Amber. I'd never blame you. God. I'm in trouble.
Why? You didn't do anything.
Now, I can count on one hand the number of people who don't think I did. I love you, Amber.
I love you too.
I have some jewelry that I'd like to give to you.
You can't come over here, Scott. There's press all over the place. Scott, you can't come over here now.
I gotta go. Okay, but I'll call you later. Okay? Bye.
Is that okay?
Perfect.
Did you know, Tommy?
Did I know?
Yeah.
About that other woman? No! Absolutely not! I've known Lacey since first grade. You think he put me in that kind of position?
You? What about the position he put Lacey in? She thought she knew him. She thought she knew Scott as well as I think I know you.
You do know me. I would never lie to you. I wouldn't know how to.
Scott had no problem lying to Lacey. No problem lying to us, to his family, everybody he loved, and everybody who loved him he lied to.
We never asked him about other women.
Jesus, Tommy! We shouldn't have to. You cannot defend this.
I am not trying to.
She is pregnant with his son, and he's out screwing...
I'm not defending him, okay? I'm pissed off at him as much as you are.
Then why don't you show it?
I'm trying to understand it. Would you just let me?
Mr. Rocha... I can't believe you kids have had this place so long, and I've never been.
Lacey, would you like a beer?
No. Glass of water.
Okay.
Sit down.
I almost missed her wedding. You remember that?
Yeah.
I was working a job. Working, and I almost missed it. I've been thinking about that. All I've missed after...
Mr. Rocha?
Lacey's alive. She is alive. Mr. Rocha.
If I'm going to represent you, you don't say another word to the police without me at your side ever again.
I've made a lot of mistakes, Mr. Whitman, in my behavior, but I would never hurt my family.
Scott, you don't know how to act in a situation like this. I mean, no one does. But that doesn't mean that you're guilty.
No, the police sure think I am.
Well, police work from percentages, and the percentages point to you.
Of course they're going to charge him. It's a matter of time. I'm not even saying the guy's guilty. You know, they could charge him for being such a callous prick, you know, for that alone.
They teach innocent until proven guilty at journalism school, or is it the other way around?
No, Tommy, you had it right the first way.
Yeah, the way you've been reporting it, it's hard to tell.
We report what we verify, Tommy.
Where do you get off? My friends call me Tommy. You're not one of them.
Scott is.
You're goddamn right he is. I know him. You don't. He's a good man. A good man.
Yeah, I'm sure Amber thinks so.
He cheated on his wife. He didn't kill her.
Have him take a polygraph. Tell him to take the polygraph.
You know, you are making him out to be some cold-blooded monster. He's a victim in this.
They're going to charge him.
Then why don't they do it?
They have enough to...
Why don't they do it?
Because they want the body.
Thank you. How long have you known Scott Peterson?
Back up, let him through.
Can you tell us what happened?
Tommy,
where are you? Tommy,
let him through,
could you tell us what happened?
Ma'am, have you spoken to the police yet?
You never told them. They never came. I had to phone them myself.
What's so important we had to meet out here on the street?
Why didn't you follow up?
You want to tell me what you're talking about?
The woman who saw Lacey. I gave you that information weeks ago.
Change your tone?
Nobody followed up.
Change your tone.
Somebody saw Lacey doing exactly what Scott said, exactly when he said. That clears him.
A lot of people say they saw Lacey.
There are others?
And they contradict one another. That's why we had to rule them out.
All of them?
It wasn't her.
Who says so?
Look, we're not a bunch of amateurs here. We say so.
People saw her. You can't...
They're wrong.
You can't peg him a killer on day one and then ignore evidence that proves he's not.
That's not what's happening. We've received over 8,000 tips. We're going through them. Every last lead, one by one.
Have you looked at anyone else?
Tommy, we have questioned and cleared over 200 suspects. We can't clear Scott.
I don't believe it, Frank. I know the guy. I know him.
You don't. You do not. And the best advice I can give you is to turn your back on him.
I don't turn my back on my friends.
All right, look on. I'm going to give you a hypothetical here. What if I told you that we found Lacey's hair in his boat? What if I told you that we found a tarp and a loaded gun in his truck? What if I told you that the jewelry Scott gave to his girlfriend turns out to be Lacey's? What do you say then?
I'd say none of it means anything, even if it is true. Not if people saw her and you can't prove they didn't.
I'm doing fine, Mom. Yeah. No, you don't have to come back up. No, I'll come down. I'll come to you.
We're worried about you.
Mom, I worry about you, okay? You're not supposed to worry about me.
Have you seen the Roches?
No.
Brent hasn't come by?
No. Mom, tell Dad I'll call him later. What?
You don't look well, Scott. You sleeping okay?
My wife is missing. I don't sleep.
Yeah. Yeah. Look, I'm going to be straight with you, okay? We found blood in your truck and Lacey's hair in your boat.
That's a lie.
Really? Where'd I start? The blood? Or the boat.
It's all lies. You're just a liar.
You're making this harder on everyone involved. You realize that, right?
Excuse me.
I have a front door. You know, I could press charges for trespassing. They can't just walk into my backyard like that.
They tried to scare you. I got a call from the DA's office, Scott. They're offering a deal. If you lead them to where the bodies are, they'll take the death penalty off the table.
Death penalty? I didn't know that was on the table.
Special circumstances apply here.
They won't call me a suspect, but they want me to confess?
That was the purpose of their visit. They figure if they put the fear of God in you, you might make their lives easier for them.
Confess to something I didn't do.
They want you scared.
Oh, I'm scared, Mr. Whitman. I'm like an outcast. The whole country thinks that I murdered my wife, my son.
That has to change. I have to change that.
I think everybody sitting at home wants the answer to the same question. Did you murder your wife?
No. No. That's just... And I had absolutely nothing to do with her disappearance. And you used the word murder. And, yeah, that's a possibility. But it's not one we're ready to accept. And it creeps in my mind late at night and early in the morning. And during the day, all we can think about is the right resolution is to find her. Well.
But as you know, increasingly, in the public, suspicion has turned on you.
Yes, definitely.
Did you ever hit her? Did you ever injure her?
No, no, my God, no. Violence against women is unapproachable. It is the most disgusting act to me. And I'm aware that suspicion has turned to me. And it's turned to me, one, because I am her husband. And that's natural thing. And I've heard all the statistics on all the news programs about how someone, husband, ex-husband, boyfriend, is someone who statistically would be one who would be responsible for her disappearance. And I'm sorry, I forgot your question.
Yes.
Ma'am, I have your daughter's car out here.
Why do you have Lacey's car?
What's wrong?
Your son-in-law, Mr. Peterson, traded the car in at my dealership.
He traded her car in?
I just don't feel right making a profit from your misfortune.
Well, we could buy the car back from you.
No, sir. I just want you to have your daughter's car, that's all. I don't want any money.
Thank you.
I told Lacey I was having an affair. We were trying to work through it.
She didn't tell me. She didn't tell her mom.
She didn't want to ruin Christmas.
You had no problem ruining hers, though, did you?
I don't know why I did it.
I don't know why you did it either, Scott. You married the most wonderful person in the world, and you risked that?
I'm ashamed of it.
You betrayed her. You hurt her. You should be ashamed. That's the least you should be.
Kate.
All I can do now is say I'm sorry. If there's anything else I could do, I would do it. I'm gonna go out of town again for a few days. I have a conference in Mexico.
How many's a few?
Three or four. A few.
Do you know what day it is? I mean, do you even know what day is coming up?
Yes. Kate, it's for work.
You know what? Screw your work. Your work is finding Lacey and Connor. That is your work, Scott.
I'm doing all I can.
I don't know who the hell you are.
I'm doing all I can.
It'll look bad, Scott.
Yeah, I know that.
It'll look bad, you not being there for her due date.
What if they find her, Scott? She's out there. She's waiting. What are we supposed to tell her?
Kate.
What? Sorry, Lacey. Scott's in Mexico. He figured you'd understand.
Kate, they've had divers in the water for weeks. You look underwater. You're looking for a body.
That was Mexico, Scott.
It's fine. What's going on?
We have a few more things we're curious about.
You guys have already been up and down the house.
Read the warrant, Scott. I need your keys. I'm going to take your truck, too.
You guys bring back the Ford?
I'm afraid not. Not yet, no.
What the hell am I supposed to drive?
Yeah.
You're killing me.
I can't talk right now, guys. Sorry.
Here we go in now, Amy. Come on, we'll be fine. We'll be okay.
Bury it good. I don't want it falling off if it hits a pothole or something.
Let go.
He's pissed off as all hell.
Did you tell him he'd have it back in a few hours?
Nope. What, I'm supposed to play Mr. Nice Nice?
Yeah, sometimes Gates, you're a real asshole.
Yeah.
Today. I was just gonna drive by and see if Scott was back. Police were there.
Yeah, they checked the house again. I heard on the news I tried to call Scott.
Amy was there too. She was waiting in the back of the police car.
Did you talk to her?
No. They waited for Scott to leave and then they took her inside.
Kate, what are you thinking?
Amy saw Scott and Lacey at the salon the night before she disappeared.
Yeah? What does that mean?
The police brought Amy there to find the clothes that Lacey had on that night. She came out of the house crying, Tommy. She couldn't find him. She couldn't find him, Tommy. She couldn't find him because Lacey died in them.
Look, that could be... If we don't know, that could be anything.
No, no! You know what? No. It couldn't be anything. This... It's specific. Those clothes are in the bay with her.
Scott. Hit.
I'm not much in the mood for this.
Come on, Tommy. Feels good. Should have gone golfing.
What?
I had a tea time on Christmas Eve. I went fishing instead.
Scott.
Of course, if I'd gone golfing, played nine holes, and Lacey'd gone missing, then it'd be... What asshole goes golfing on Christmas Eve?
It wasn't the holiday that bothered people. It was leaving her pregnant and alone, ready to deliver.
Lacey wasn't worried. She was only at 8 months. They measured her house today. My lawyer tells me that's because they think that Lacey died there, in our house. They'll make all kinds of diagrams when they take me to trial. What are people saying in town?
I'm in the kitchen. I don't hear.
Press bothering you?
They talk. I don't listen.
You pay a penalty these days being friends with me. I don't know what I'd do without you and Kate.
You and Lacey wouldn't do any less.
You can ask, you know. Any questions you have. I appreciate that you don't, but you can.
Why don't you take the lie detector test?
My lawyer advised me not to.
But you'll pass. I mean, that'll prove something.
Polygraphs can give you false positives. You're innocent. Machine says you're guilty.
Why don't you talk about Connor?
It's too painful. It's just too painful to talk about him.
Hey, Scott, John from KFI.
What did you do with your wife? No one believes your story. You know where she is? Why don't you tell us where she is? You're not fooling anybody with your phony story. We just have one question. Where did you put your wife and baby? You're searching for the truth. Why don't you just come and talk to us and tell us the truth?
Yeah.
Scott, we found Connor's body in the bay. It's only a matter of time before we find Lacey.
Were found 2 miles from the body of the infant discovered yesterday. Both bodies were found within miles of where Scott Peterson claimed he went fishing on Christmas Eve.
The remains of a woman believed to be Lacey Peterson were discovered today just miles from where her husband, Scott Peterson, claimed he went fishing on the day of her
Autopsies are being performed, but positive IDs will likely depend on DNA analysis.
Why is that?
Well, due to the condition of the bodies, we're not able to lift fingerprints or check dental records.
Fingerprints wear off in the water. Why not dental records?
We'll update you as soon as we know more.
God, we don't have her head. I miss you.
Are you okay? I saw on the TV that...
Can I come see you? Now, right this minute.
It's not a good idea.
I need to be with you, Amber.
The press will find you.
I don't care.
Scott, I know you're hurting. I want to see you too, but it will look bad for you.
Can't look any worse. Doesn't matter. They found them. They found him. I don't know what I'm gonna do. What am I gonna do?
Scott, do you have anything that you wanna tell me?
What do you mean?
Should I be afraid? Should I be afraid of you?
No. Please don't even say that. Don't. Be afraid, that would kill me.
You had nothing to do with this.
No, I had nothing, nothing to do with it.
Scott.
I swear I had nothing to do with it. But I know who did.
What?
I can't tell you right now. But I'll tell you when I see you.
I promise. I promise I won't lie to you, Amber. I'll tell you. I'll tell you when I see you.
I swear I had nothing to do with it, but I know who did. I know who did.
What the hell does that mean?
It means nothing. Bullshit. Scott bragging to his girlfriend.
Let's see where he's going. Fresno. Pulled off from Fresno. Shit. He's going to Amber's.
What the hell are you doing?
Getting the unit over to her place.
Wait a minute. You heard Scott on the phone. I know who did it, and I'll tell you when I see you, Frank. We could be just minutes away from a confession.
He could hurt her.
He won't hurt her. Not now. He's not insane.
We think he killed his wife and kid. Is that sane?
I'm telling you, we're going to get the son of a bitch now.
I'm not willing to risk her safety. Why are you?
I'm not going to risk her safety. We'll have
you
the place covered, but we'll have the
right
place
now.
Covered. But we're going to nail him. We're going to nail him now.
Put a satellite tracker on your truck. That's how they found you.
When is this gonna end?
Look, if they had the evidence to arrest you, they would. They don't. So take some comfort in that.
Where's he going? Hey, why aren't you taking this thing off?
Hey, he can't. He can't. Look, they had to get a warrant to do this. They did it legally.
What? So I can't legally remove it?
Just don't go near the crime scene.
The police think I live in the crime scene.
Scott.
Go inside, get a juice box, okay? Mommy, be right in. Go inside, shut the door.
Hey, Tommy home?
No.
Is he gonna be home later tonight?
I don't know.
Will you be here? Could you just tell Tommy I came by? I'm going out of town again. Probably won't see you guys for a while.
Where you going?
Where would you go? The whole world thought you were a murderer.
Depends.
On what?
If I was.
No matter what happens, Kate, or what you think of me, just know that I wanted what you have.
Gates? His truck just sitting there in San Diego. Hadn't moved in 24 hours. He may be gone.
Guy was in Mexico once already. He didn't run then.
We hadn't found the bodies then. Phone San Diego. I want some live eyes on him down there.
Why not pick him up?
When we match the DNA, when we know for certain that it's Lacey and Connor, I'll put the cuffs on him myself.
He said we wouldn't see him for a while.
He'll be back. Cops will bring him back. Parade him down McHenry.
I think he was saying goodbye for good, Tommy. I think he's gonna run.
He'd run if he killed her.
If he was going to run, he would have. If he was guilty, he would be in
Tommy,
Mexico.
Come on, please.
He would have stayed the first time. He wouldn't have come back.
Tommy, Lacey is dead. And Connor is dead. He killed them. Scott killed them.
No. It doesn't make any sense.
Everything he's said and done has been suspect.
Says who? How are you supposed to act when your wife goes missing? How are you supposed to act?
Like a husband acts, Tommy. Like a father acts. I mean, come on. If I went missing, you would be crazy. You would go to the ends of the earth. You'd confess every sin that you'd ever committed.
I've seen. And you've seen. You've seen how he is with Sammy.
Maybe she found out about the affair. Maybe she found out and she threatened to leave, and maybe they fought. Maybe it was an accident. I don't know.
People saw her that morning, Kate.
The police talked to those people.
People saw Lacey, just like Scott said.
They ruled them out, dammit!
God damn it, Kate! I saw him in the nursery. I helped him put that crib together. He wanted that baby.
Does the chief want to wait on the final serology report?
Yeah, we wait for the final, we could lose a day.
It'll leak if we wait.
It will leak.
Ross?
Yeah.
It's positive.
Okay. Thanks.
Prelim matched. Lacey and Connor.
We need to stop for gas.
We're going to San Diego.
Police authorized the arrest of Scott Peterson.
He was arrested in San Diego, a 30-mile sprint from the Mexican border, with his brother's ID and what has been reported as a large sum of money on his person.
Disguising himself by dyeing his hair and beard, Modesto detectives are returning Peterson to the Stanislaus County Jail here in downtown Modesto to be held pending arraignment.
December 24th, 2002, shortly after 5:15 p.m., I received a phone call and heard the devastating words that would forever change my life. Lacey's missing. I knew in my heart that something terrible had happened to my daughter and my grandson. My world collapsed around me. Since receiving the phone call, we've been living a terrible nightmare. I love my daughter so much. I miss her every minute of every day. No parent should ever have to think about the way their child was murdered.
Tommy.
And Kate.
And Sammy. We're not here right now.
We'll get back to you if you leave a message.
Bye.
Hey, guys. Tommy. It's Scott. I just wanted to tell you, I'm in jail. So, I won't be able to talk to you guys for a while. I'll try to call you when I get a chance, and,
About 3 years ago at our grandmother's funeral, Lacey had mentioned to me, well, you know, when I die, I don't want people to be sad. I don't want people to be missing me. I want people to be happy. So, I'm up here to convey that to everyone here. That Lacey would want us to have happiness in our hearts for her, and that we had the opportunity to know her.